Welcome to Lightspeed's video support for K-Series. I'm Vinny, and in this video, we'll show you how to set up your kitchen display system. The Lightspeed Kitchen Display System, or KDS, gives you a live view of the status of your orders for each production station in your restaurant. Here's how it works. When you place an order on one of your POS devices, it's sent to a dedicated POS device that acts as the hub for your KDS. Each KDS screen at your production stations accesses the hub through your local network. Orders are then displayed on each screen according to how you've configured them. For instance, you can set up one screen at the grill and another at the bar. When a server takes an order for a cheeseburger and cocktail, the burger can be sent to the screen at the grill and the cocktail to the screen at the bar. Once orders appear on the KDS, staff can then change the order status to indicate when it's been started and when it's ready. Orders can also be held or cancelled as needed. First, you'll need to enable KDS 2.0 on your account. Contact your sales account manager for any assistance you might need. Once set up, your hub must always remain on with the Lightspeed app open for the system to function, so we recommend keeping the hub plugged in at all times. When you're selecting a device for your KDS hub, keep in mind that KDS 2.0 only supports the two most recent versions of iOS, so ensure the selected device can run one of those operating system versions. When your hub is up and running, select a tablet or any device with a browser to act as the KDS screen for your station. Once Lightspeed has activated KDS for your account, you'll be able to start setting up your hub. The first step to getting your KDS up and running is assigning a dedicated POS to act as the hub. In the K-Series app on your selected POS device, go to Settings, Kitchen Display System. Ensure you're on the latest version of the app by tapping Check for Updates. If updates are available, be sure to install them. Once you're up to date, we'll need to assign a permanent or static IP address for the hub so KDS screens will always be able to communicate with it. Please consult with your network administrator or provider before making any changes. Open the iOS Settings app and tap Wi-Fi. Open your Wi-Fi network settings by tapping the name for that connection. Find the field named IPv4 address and write it down. We'll need this shortly. To set up the static IP address, tap Configure IP, then tap Manual. For IP address, enter the IPv4 address that we wrote down earlier. For subnet mask, enter 255.255.0.0. For router, re-enter the IPv4 address, but change the final group of numbers to 1. Once you save your settings, the static IP address will be assigned. To enable the KDS screens to communicate with the hub, you'll need some information from the Lightspeed app. In the app, go to Settings, Kitchen Display System. Write down the IP address displayed and the 4-digit connection code. Next, on the device you want to use as the KDS screen, connect to the same local network as your hub and open a browser. In the address bar, enter the IP address of the KDS hub from the previous step and press Enter. When prompted, enter the 4-digit connection code that you wrote down. On the splash page, tap Create New Station. On the station name step, we'll need to give the KDS screen a unique name. This could be anything up to 25 characters long. We recommend naming it something identifiable that indicates where this screen is located. Once you've entered a name, tap Save and Continue. Next, we'll configure how orders are set to your KDS screen. The following options can be modified after setup via the Settings menu, so you can always change your mind later. On the Routing step, select the items you'd like to be sent to this KDS screen. You can do this by selecting individual items from the list of items. However, for simplicity, we recommend selecting groups of items all at once by using the accounting groups or menu categories. Once you've selected your items, tap Add Items to Station. The Ticket Settings step, choose what information to display on each ticket. You can select to show or hide the following: customer name, order ID, number of customers, server, type, floor, order source, and pickup time. Once you've selected what information to display, tap Save and Continue. On the Order Status step, review the order statuses available to match your business's workflow. If your workflow doesn't need the statuses for new or ready to collect, you can disable them by tapping the deactivate button. Once your workflow is set, tap save and continue. Now you're ready to receive and display orders using KDS. For more information on using KDS, check out our companion video or visit the articles in our Help Center. If you have any questions, check out the links in the description below.